Kelly Shackelford just finished speaking at an event here in Dallas, and I've been trying to catch up with him, and you were a hard person to catch up with. Yesterday, he was speaking here in this room. Then you caught a flight to D.C. last night for the confirmation of Amy Coney Barrett, and then back again today. But we want to talk about last night, not the event today. Tell me what it was like being there for the swearing-in ceremony for a new Supreme Court justice.
Well, that's the reason I went through all that. I mean, there was no way I was going to miss that. It was a huge part of history. There's probably people who have spent, you know, 40 years of their life on that day. Certainly we, the last 4 years as we've worked on judges, it was certainly the culmination of everything we've worked for. To have somebody that excellent and to have the balance of the court really shift in a solid way. I mean, this is the first time in 80 years that we've had a reliably conservative Supreme Court. Not that you get conservative results on policy, that's not what I'm talking about, on judges who really want to be judges and not legislate from the bench, and it's just going to change our country. So, such an honor to be there. Of course, usually you do these swearing-ins like in a hallway with four people.
That's what I was telling my wife and son. I said, it'll be a private ceremony and you'll see a White House photo. No, there's a band.
No, it's President Trump is somewhat of a showman, and so as I'm walking onto the White House lawn, there's a military band playing,
And they were good.
Yeah, they were awesome. And the White House is spectacular. I mean, it's just beautiful. The flags, what they have set up, the whole thing was just, it's just memorable. And you know, the thing that I couldn't help thinking was that all of our supporters were sitting there with me. You know, there weren't a lot of chairs there. They were all spread apart because of social distancing.
Yeah.
But I felt like everybody was sitting in the chair with me. And it's almost like I've said before, everybody's fingerprints were on Amy Coney Barrett. Nobody could see them. But there's a lot of people that really made that happen. And a lot of prayer and just a lot of people being faithful. And I was there with leaders of other groups who'd been very faithful. Pro-life groups that had worked for years to stop the activism from the court that were there. It was a special night, and then to see Justice Thomas, of all people, be the person to administer the oath. I mean, I thought that was really powerful too, because he is now the intellectual conservative leader of the court for proper judicial philosophy. And for him to do it just added even a little extra.
Well, Andy was very good friends with Justice Antonin Scalia.
Yes, he
and
was.
She likes to describe herself as being in the mold of Scalia. Do you see that shadow?
Oh, yeah, yeah. She's, she's very unique because she's not only brilliant, she's not only very well-spoken and obviously very measured. At the same time, she's a mom with a minivan and two adopted children and all this. But she was a professor for a long time, and she wrote extensively on the proper way for judges to deal with cases. That whole thing that Scalia sort of taught her about originalism and looking to the original meaning, she went deep in that and how you do it and how you don't do it. And so it's very unique that somebody comes to the court not only with all this experience she had and brilliance and proper temperament and everything else, but she actually taught and wrote on how to be a good judge. And I just think she might end up being one of the best justices in the history of our country.
Now, I watched this on C-SPAN, so I had a different view than you did. But when you think back on that evening, from a personal perspective, what's the one thing that you'll remember that stood out to you as that's the thing I want to hang on to?
You know, I mean, it was mainly just the moment of it. This is a turning point in our history that we watch. I mean, it might be one of those things that people remember as they watched it on TV. Because as I was sitting there, and everybody around me, you could feel it, we knew this was historic. Not just another justice. This was really big. And this was a turning point in the history of our country. And we'll see. We'll know more in the future as we look back what this really meant.
Yeah.
But I think we'll look back, and that's what I remember. I just remember the feel. And, of course, again, I really do appreciate what the president did to make it even more special, because he made it what it should be. He made it bigger. It shouldn't be in a hallway, right? It should be with that kind of beauty in between the White House and the National Monument, with the flags and the military band. This is one-third of our government, the judiciary, and And this was an excellent, we just can't, we couldn't pick a better choice to go on the Supreme Court. Here's the interesting thing is, you know, that was last night. By this morning, she had gotten the second oath of office, which now means she is now on the court. Yeah. She is already working as a Supreme Court justice. So she's having to hit the ground running.
Yeah, excellent. Hey, thank you for making time for us. So grateful and proud of you for getting that invite to be there last night and see it in person. And thank you for being part of First Liberty. This is something you got to be part of, and we're grateful for you as well. Thank you.